Hey guys, and welcome back for another video. Now, in today's video, we're going to go over the top six OnlyFans agency owner mistakes that I see happening in today's market. So, if you're someone who's looking to build and scale an OnlyFans agency, you're going to find this video is super valuable because I have a lot of industry experience. And basically, I know a lot of the problems that some people face. And here's the top six ones that I see. So, hopefully, it can help you get to the next step or help you see where you're going wrong with your current OnlyFans agency if you already started one. Okay, cool. Chances are, if you're in the actual OnlyFans agency space, you know that you've come in here because you've heard some get rich quick scheme from some online influencer. Perhaps you've heard Andrew Tate doing his own OnlyFans agency and you're looking to start one yourself. Or you've typed in how to make money online on Google and you've found SMMA and then you've been filtered down into picking this niche for social media marketing agency. So the chances are lots of you found this video by very different routes, but you all got the same underlying issues because you're coming at it from a weird frame when it comes to how to make money fast online. So I've got some notes on the side of this video to help me keep organized with this. So we're just going to roll off each and every mistake, and I'm going to tell you why it's crucial that you do not make that mistake again. So the first mistake that I see when people join the OnlyFans agency or they're trying to actually grow the OnlyFans agency is they don't do enough outreach. It's the number one mistake that I see people make because, of course, when you're building an OnlyFans agency, you haven't got an agency unless you've got clients to serve, which is going to be, in our case, OnlyFans models. So you need to go out of your way to actually message these OnlyFans models to get them hopped on a call with you so you can actually sign them on as a client. And I see people saying, oh, I'm struggling to actually sign these models. And I simply ask them the question, how much outreach are you doing every single day? And they say, well, I'm sending 20 messages a day on, Facebook or Instagram or some platform like that. And that's simply not enough outreach. You can't expect to be sending 20 messages a day and get tons of positive replies and get tons of new business for your agency. Bare minimum, I'd recommend doing 50 messages per day. Now, that may seem like a lot to some of you, but of course, you don't have to do that yourself. You can outsource that to a virtual assistant, or you can actually just bang it out in an initial period. And then once you get a few clients, you can kind of ease off the outreach. But you need to be doing more outreach. Doing the bare minimum is not enough. I know this may be some, it seemed like a quick get rich easy scheme, but at the end of the day, you're going out into the world, you're signing on clients for your services. So this is a proper legitimate business, and you need to make sure that you're putting in the work when it comes to outreaching to these clients. And this leads me to the second issue that I see people making, which is analysis paralysis. And I cannot stress enough that chances are, if you're taking longer than a single week to set up your agency in terms of setting up the website, setting up your logo, I can guarantee that you're going to be struggling building this OnlyFans agency for years to come. Now, the reason I can say that with absolute confidence is because a few years ago, I was in the exact same situation where I wasn't in the actual OnlyFans agency business model. I started that a year and a half ago. But before then, 3 years ago, I was in the actual agency industry. I had a search engine optimization agency, and I spent so long on making these small little tweaks to the logo, small little tweaks to the website design, and it just took me so long to set up the actual agency foundations itself, where it really does not need to take you that long. And if you're at that stage, then you've got a lot to learn. You've seriously got a lot to learn because a client or a potential model who's going to work with the agency is going to be looking at your logo and thinking, you know what? If they had one little squiggle below that letter there, maybe, just maybe, I'll join their agency. That's just not reality. And if you're fixed on small little things like that, then you've got a lot to learn when it comes to the actual game of business and what you actually need to be focusing on. And you've got a lot of issues in terms of your mindset when it comes to it. There's things that I personally had to iron out, had to get out of my system, was the fixation on OCD and just basically making sure that everything needs to be perfect before you launch it. There is going to be no perfection. It's simply you reiterate what you've done and you improve upon it upon time and you will get better, okay? So that's the second mistake that I see a lot of people make. Now, the third mistake I see a lot of people do is they do not provide value to the market they're looking to serve. If you're building an OnlyFans agency, you need to provide value to the OnlyFans market. So you need to provide value to the models that you're reaching out to. I see, you can apply this to any business that you want to start. If you want to start a business, you need to provide value to the market that you're serving. And I see so many people just go into a market, they beg, oh, please hop on a call with me. I promise that, you know, I can actually help you on this call. I really want to pitch you, I really want to sell you, just constantly pitching their services when you're not actually going out of the way to look at these OnlyFans models or these, you know, people in whatever industry you're serving. And then look, how can I provide value to these people? And the reason it's crucial is because the law of reciprocity is real. If you provide value to people, they will notice that and they will sense that and they'll want to return that value that you've provided them. So make sure you're providing value to this market because it's just going to make everything so much easier. Now, mistake number four I see people doing, and I did myself, was you copy other people in terms of, you see someone who's successful, you think, wow, they must be doing something right. And then you just copy what they're doing, where that is not going to work and you're going to have a lot to learn when you do that because you're just copying what you see on the surface level. When in actual fact, you're not understanding the underlying reason of why they're doing that exact thing. And the reason that's crucial is because, you know, chances are if an agency is doing a particular thing, for example, my agency serves an audit to the clients that we sign on, and that's a way of me providing value to the market. And essentially, the audit feeds into other systems in the back end, which make the audit valuable itself. The audit is not valuable itself. It's the systems in the back end that I have running for my agency, which make that audit valuable. And there's no way of you knowing that. So some people out there have just copied my audit, and they think they're going to be successful. And, you know, that is not the case because they're not doing the underlying back end, you know, system improvements, or they're not making that audit feed into other systems. So you need to basically understand why is someone doing that. And you need to understand that how that integrates into the business. Otherwise, you're just not going to have any success copying someone's website or copying a particular, you know, feature they're using. You need to understand the reason behind it. Now, mistake number five I see is people start businesses with zero money. I'm talking about zero money. The amount of calls that I hopped on with people saying, yeah, I've just really got no money, but I'm trying to start this business. It's not going to work. You really do need to save up some money before you start any business. Otherwise, you're going to be struggling. Now, the reason I say that is because you can't, you know, if you went back a few years ago, it'd be crazy to think that you'd want to just go into a brick and mortar business and start it from scratch with zero money. And in the end of the day, you are building a legitimate business, so you need to invest some money. And it's not like you can't do it if you've got zero money. You can make this work, especially the OnlyFans agency business model, because there's, you know, very little upfront costs needed. But, you know, in terms of actually having capital or having access to capital, it's going to make it a lot harder if you do not have that capital to access. In terms of having capital to pay someone to help teach you some specific thing, I cannot stress how important it is to invest in actually learning and invest in getting knowledge yourself, as well as actually invest in particular systems which are going to help out your agency. And you know, there's so much that you need to invest money into when you start any business. And to think that you're just going to go out there with $0 and you're going to be able to build the next multi-million dollar business is ludicrous. You really do need some upfront capital. And it's an issue that I faced a few years ago. If I could go back, I would have saved up more money and then gone and full-time into business, because of the fact that if you've got money to invest, you can invest it into people and they can teach their knowledge and they can then bring you up to their level. Whereas if you've got no money and you're trying to figure this all out for yourself, it's going to take you so much longer than it needs to be, rather than someone who is just investing in, you know, knowledge from someone who's already been there and done this before, and they're just going to get that knowledge instantly. So they're just going to be years ahead of you purely because they've got access to that capital. Now, mistake number six that I see people make is they set unrealistic expectations. They expect to be rich after 1 month, and in actual fact, it takes years of knowledge to actually be able to experience that rapid success. And you know, when you see people who are overnight successes, you know, they aren't overnight successes. The reality is they've put years and, you know, absolute tons of effort and work in the back end, and finally something's popped off and they're having a bit of success. So there's no such thing as an overnight success. The actual case is that they've been learning, perfecting the craft for years, and you haven't actually seen the work they've been putting in, and then they start to see the fruition of their labor, and people label them as an overnight success. So really having unrealistic expectations when it comes to it is a mistake that I see a lot of people make, where they think that they know that they've got no business knowledge, and they're just starting their first business, and they expect that they're going to make tons and tons and tons of money from it with no help from anyone else, where that's just not the case. You know, you can actually achieve unrealistic results if you go to someone who's achieved the results already and they can just show you exactly how to achieve the same results. Then that's how people become overnight successes, in the sense of they have someone who helps them, you know, who basically fast tracks and skips all the mistakes that they need to make in order to get up to the actual level of success. So yeah, I hope this video was of value to you guys, and maybe one of these mistakes is very prevalent in your business right now or in your life right now. And if that is the case, make sure to book in a call with myself down below, and I can talk you through it, because I've been there. I've you know, I've been developing this business over the last few years. I've made every mistake you can possibly imagine, but that's how you're going to learn. You're going to learn through trial and error, and you can fast track your success by skipping all these mistakes and learning from someone who's already made these mistakes and overcome them. Okay, so yeah, make sure you book in a call below, or if you want some free information, you can also subscribe down below to the actual OnlyFans ANC roadmap, which will show you exactly what you need to do to get from 0 to 50k plus per month in 90 days. And you can also join my Facebook group, where we do live community trainings, and you'll get access to some templates and resources as well. So I'll see you guys in the next video.